Have you ever wondered, where is God? What's he up to? My granddaughter Sophie sure does. She was 4 and fiercely brave when a huge hardcover book just jumped off a shelf and, ow, landed on her tiny foot. On the way to ER, that foot turned 3 shades of blue. It was a nasty gash. Mom, Sophie said, I wish Jesus wasn't invisible so he could come and hold my hand. Well, me too, little girl. David Flood knew the feeling. In 1921, he and his wife Svea left Sweden to take the good news of Jesus to a remote area of Africa. The chief said no, so they built a mud hut nearby and prayed for a breakthrough. None came. A boy came to see them. Svea told him of Jesus, the God who would rather die than live without him, but that was it. Pregnant, Svea endured malaria, gave birth to a little girl, and died. Her grieving husband David dug a rough grave for her, handed his daughter to another missionary couple and announced, I'm going back to Sweden. I've lost my wife. I can't take care of this baby. God has ruined my life. The little girl grew up in South Dakota. Her parents named her Aggie. Aggie married and gave birth to 2 children. One day, a magazine appeared in her mailbox. A photo stopped her cold. A grave. A white cross. The words, Svea Flood. The story was of missionaries, the birth of a baby, the death of a young mother, and of one little African boy she led to Jesus. That boy grew up and built a school. In time, all the students trusted Jesus, the chief too. There were 600 Christians in the village now, all because her parents, David and Svea Flood, were there. For their 25th anniversary, Aggie and her husband visited Sweden, where Aggie learned that David Flood had given his life over to alcohol. Don't mention God, she was told. In a rundown building, Aggie found her father. 73 now, he suffered from diabetes. Cataracts covered both eyes. Aggie fell to his side crying, Papa, I'm your little girl, the one you left in Africa. I never meant to give you away, he said. I just couldn't handle things. It's all right, Papa. God took good care of me. And he stiffened. God forgot us all, he said. Papa, Aggie continued. Mama didn't die in vain. The little boy you brought to Jesus told his whole village about God. The one seed you planted kept growing and growing. There are at least 600 Christians there because you were faithful, Papa. Jesus loves you. He never hated you. David Flood broke. Tears of sorrow and repentance flowed down his face, and he prayed, recommitting his life to Jesus. Within a few weeks, he was gone. Years later, Aggie and her husband attended a conference in London, England, where a speaker brought greetings from Aggie's birthplace. He represented 110,000 believers. Afterwards, Aggie asked him, have you ever heard of David and Svea Flood? His eyes grew wide. Yes, madam. Svea Flood led me to Jesus when I was just a little boy. They had a baby girl. I don't know what happened to her. I'm that girl, said Aggie. I don't pretend to understand the ways of God. That would be like an aardvark understanding the internet. But in the midst of our hurt and anxiety, an all-powerful, sovereign God is working things together for good. He is active. He cares. Don't give up, my friend. Seeds you are sowing now will bear fruit one day. Maybe not this week or even next year. But God will not waste your hurt. He is in the midst of whatever you're up against. In even this, God is sovereign. Hebrews 1:3 says he sustains all things. My counsel shall stand. Isaiah 46:10 tells us, and I will accomplish all my purpose. I cannot run the world, but he can. I cannot understand all that much, but he knows all. I cannot quite see it from here, but it's true. Heaven's throne is occupied and all is well. With Sophie's foot finally bandaged, her mom drove her home. Suddenly, Sophie started to laugh. Ha! Jesus is making it not hurt as much as it should, she said. Jesus gave me you, mommy. You hold my hand. You're right, Sophie. Jesus holds your hand, little girl. Never let go. And never forget, Jesus has scars too. Laughter is phenomenal medicine. Share it, like it, pass it on by subscribing to the button that you subscribe to. Then, hey, take the rest of the day off.